Hello, I'm Christopher Clarke, and today I'm going to talk to you about brain waves. What are they? What are the most commonly measured brain waves? What do they do? And how can you improve your brain waves and your neural connectivity? So what are brain waves? Well, they're electrical signals that reflect brain activity. Each wavelength varies in speed, and that's measured in hertz. Each area of the brain can be evaluated based on which wavelength is more dominant at that time. And these give researchers an insight into a person's mental state. For example, an excessive amount of a particular brain wave may indicate a learning disability or a neurological injury. So what are the most commonly measured brain waves? Well, there's delta, theta, alpha, and beta. There's also gamma, but that's not really commonly measured. The delta wavelength occurs at about 1 to 4 hertz, and that's deep sleep. When you're asleep and you're in this particular delta wavelength, no dreaming occurs. If you wake up while you're in delta, you're typically super confused. You don't know where you are. You're wondering, who is this person sleeping next to me? However, when you're in this particular wavelength while you're sleeping, it improves your hippocampus function, which is required for memory storage. The benefit of this restorative wavelength is that it encourages your body to release human growth hormone. The next wavelength is theta. This occurs between about 4 and 7 hertz, and this is a very dreamy stage of sleep. When you're in REM sleep, you're in theta. Theta can also occur when you're awake, when you're daydreaming. For example, if you're driving down the road, it's very monotonous. You look down and you're going 60 miles an hour and you blink and you realize, oh my God, where did the past 60 miles go? I don't even remember that happening. Alpha is a relaxed state of brainwave. It occurs between 8 and 12 hertz. This is more visualization. It has a bit of some daydream tendencies, but you're awake, you're aware. If you've ever heard of the athletes getting in the zone, they are visualizing a perfect execution of that play, and then when they go out on the field, they execute it accordingly. The next wavelength that we're going to discuss is beta. Beta happens between 12 and 40 hertz. This is a very conscious reasoning, a very focused wavelength. Beta, for instance, happens when you are giving a talk or a presentation and you're standing in front of a large crowd. You're thinking and hyper-focused on your information that you're disseminating to the crowd. You're also looking at their faces, engaging their response. Therefore, beta is very much associated with an engaged brain. People who think very logically and not so creatively are typically more beta-centric wavelength people. The downsides, however, to beta is that it can cause anxiety and stress. Also, headaches due to the increased blood flow to the brain. But the positives to beta are an increased level of alertness, improved focus, very goal-oriented concentration, quick thinking ability, higher self-confidence, and an increase in problem-solving capacity. So what do these brain waves do? Well, each brain wave has its associated use and helps support the state of mind required for the task at hand. So how do we measure them? Here at Clarke Bioscience, we utilize a wavi. The wavi is an EEG ERP, or evoked response potential. The software in the wavi is designed to elicit certain wavelengths at particular points in the testing. So how can you tap into your brain waves? Well, one of the best ways is meditation. During meditation, you can increase your alpha wavelengths. You can also increase your beta wavelengths if you practice problem-solving skills during your session. Another way is through binaural beats. This is when you wear headphones and your one ear hears a tone and another ear hears a slightly different tone. This will actually slow your brain waves and increase relaxation. A third way is through music therapy. Music therapy will increase your alpha wavelength. It will allow you to be more creative, especially when you visualize the music and not just hear it. So how can we improve our brain waves and our neural connectivity? Well, the best way is to lower your inflammation levels. So through diet, exercise, your environment, you want to decrease the things that promote inflammation within your body. The other way is to increase blood flow to your brain. And that also can be done through exercise. Supplementation is a great way to do it. We use Nupinex here. Nupinex also has things in it that will allow you to calm down, focus, and it helps you get deep restorative sleep as well. Well, this has just been a very broad overview of brain waves and what they can do and what they mean. I hope you enjoyed it, and I really hope you come back and check out the other content that we have available. Until next time, we'll see you soon.